Ratios. Degree ratios. Under that, first we will have debt equity ratio. Second one, debt assets ratio. And the third one, interest coverage ratio. So let's we learn what will be the formulas for these three ratios. So you all know that equity is nothing but shareholders' funds, assets is nothing but fixed assets, and the interest is nothing but we enter the bank loan with the interest. So first we write the formula here for debt equity ratio. So debt equity ratio, equity means shareholders' funds. It will deal with the shareholder funds. And under the shareholders funds, we have to deal with the debt equity ratio. Man we have debt and equity appu. So manam ekkariki appu pesali. So normally appu ane em ostundi, long term liabilities, not the short term liabilities. So here we have to deal only with the long term debts. Short term is easy to pay, long term nunchi eppudu aalochistam. So the formula will be long term debts divided by shareholder funds. So next comes to the debt assets ratio. So assets eppudu kuda manam ala same ikkada nominal laage we take with the fixed assets, not with the current long, that is fixed assets. And fixed assets always ikkada vastam given the debts. The formula will be the total debts. Ante enti manam assets kone tappudu definitely we have to pay the amount. So every question here I am considering only the long term debts. But here I am considering the total debts. There is nothing but short term and the long term debts I will consider here. There is a formula for debt assets ratio. Means your debts are dealing with the assets and debts are dealing with the equities. And this comes to the interest coverage ratio. In the interest coverage ratio, we will have to pay the interest. We have to pay the interest on the loans taken, or we have to pay the interest on the creditors amount, or let it be anything else. And that interest amount, it deals manam interest eppudu pay chestam ela pay chestam manaku profit vaste tappa manaku interest pay cheyadu profit raakunda interest pay cheyochu anukuntam we can't pay. So you know what we have to do, we will write the formula as earnings before interest and tax and interest charges. So earnings is nothing but, again we can say it is nothing but a profit. Here I am taking the profit before interest and tax. Interest and tax manam pay cheyakapothe manaku profit untundi, aa profit nunchi manam interest pay chestam. So interest coverage ratio deal with the earnings before interest and tax divided by the interest charges. So in this way we have to remember the formula for the leverage ratios. The leverage ratios will calculate based on three things. One is debt equity ratio, debt assets ratio, and the interest coverage ratio. Debt equity ratio is nothing but what are the debts we have to pay based on our equity. Equity is nothing but shareholders' funds. Debt assets ratio, total debts divided by fixed assets. Interest coverage ratio is equal to earnings before interest and tax divided by interest charges. So in the easy way we have to remember the formula. We should not buy under the ratio analysis. Okay. So let's go with the last one, this fifth one, other ratios. So the last ratios formula as fifth one, that is this as other ratios. Okay, the other ratios we have five formulas. The first one is operating ratio, and the second one operating profit ratio, and the third one selling and distribution expenses ratio, and the fourth one administrative expenses ratio, and the last one fifth one proprietary ratio. సో ఒకసారి మనం ఈ సైడ్ చూద్దాం ఆపరేటింగ్ రేషియో ఆపరేటింగ్ ప్రాఫిట్ రేషియో సెల్లింగ్ అండ్ డిస్ట్రిబ్యూటెడ్ ఎక్స్పెన్షన్ రేషియోస్ అడ్మినిస్ట్రేటివ్ ఎక్స్పెన్సెస్ రేషియో అండ్ ద ప్రొప్రైటరీ రేషియో సో ఫస్ట్ విల్ రైట్ ద ఫార్ములాస్ సో ఆపరేటింగ్ రేషియో మీన్స్ వి హావ్ టు ఫైండ్ అవుట్ ద ఆల్ ద ఆపరేటింగ్ ఎక్స్పెన్సెస్ విచ్ డీస్ ఇన్ ద కంపెనీ ఎక్స్పెన్సెస్ అనేది మనం దేనికోసం పెడతాం ఓన్లీ టు ఫర్ ద డూయింగ్ ద సేల్స్ సేల్స్ ఉంటేనే ఏమైనా ఎక్స్పెన్సెస్ ఉంటాయి సేల్స్ ఎలా ఉంటే ఇలాంటి ఎక్స్పెన్సెస్ కూడా ఉన్నాయి సో బేసికలీ ఆల్ ద ఫార్ములాస్ ఆల్ ద రేషియోస్ హియర్ కంపేర్ ఓన్లీ విత్ ద సేల్స్ సో వాట్ ఇస్ ద ఫార్ములా ఆఫ్ ఆపరేటింగ్ రేషియో హియర్ ఇట్ షుడ్ డీల్ విత్ ద సేల్స్ ఇట్ షుడ్ డీల్ విత్ ద సేల్స్ ఇట్ షుడ్ డీల్ విత్ ద సేల్స్ అండ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఆల్సో సేమ్ డీల్ విత్ ద సేల్స్ సో సేల్స్ ఏం డీల్ చేస్తాం normally expenses expenses are the cost of goods sold that is purchases opening stock and the direct expenses plus operating expenses operating expenses so what is the formula cost of goods sold plus operating expenses divided by sales into 100 sales lo edi is anni expenses anamata purchases vastundi opening stock vastundi direct expenses vastayi and indirect expenses all divided by sales 200. But when it comes to the operating profit ratio, here we deal only with the operating profit. Operating profit divided by sales into 100. And again, the operating profit is the only sales. So, when sales is the operating profit, it is the same. So, profit is the same. So, selling and distribution expenses could have selling and distribution expenses into 100. The formula will be the selling and distribution expenses divided by sales into 100. So next comes to the administrative expenses. So ikkada kuda manam aa ratio find out chestam kabatti administrative expenses divided by sales into 100. So normally ఏంటి అన్ని కూడా sales తోనే డీల్ చేస్తుంది. So what we are going to find out will be the main topic here. Of cost of goods sold plus operating expenses divided by sales into 100, operating profit divided by sales into 100 to find the operating profit ratio, selling and distribution expenses divided by sales into 100 in the place of selling and distribution expenses, for administrative expenses ratio, administrative expenses divided by sales into 100. So just comes to the proprietary ratio now. So proprietary ratio. Proprietary ratio means first of all, proprietary is nothing but owner of the company. But normally, tells me that your company ki owner is proprietor. So proprietor ki, atan ki em find out chesta. So proprietor kavalsindi enti, atan funds enti. Company lo unna atan funds. Ante shareholder funds. Mana find out chesindi shareholder funds. Dento em chestundi mana funds ela telustayi. ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఒక ఇల్లు ఉంది ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ మా ఇల్లు ఉంది మా ఇంట్లో ఉన్న ఆస్తులు ఏంటి అంటే నాకు ఎలా తెలుస్తుంది అసలు నేను తెచ్చింది ఏంటి అంటే నా రిఫ్రిజిరేటర్ నా టీవీ నా బైక్ నా ల్యాప్టాప్ ఉంటుంది అసెట్స్ ఏమైనా ల్యాండ్ బిల్డింగ్ మిషనరీ ఏవైతే ఉన్నాయో మీన్స్ మై ఫండ్స్ విల్ బీ కంపేర్ ఓన్లీ విత్ ద వర్త్ అసెట్స్ వి హావ్ సో ఐ విల్ డీల్ విత్ ద టోటల్ అసెట్స్ ఆఫ్ ద కంపెనీ సో వెన్ వీ కెన్ ఫైండ్ అవుట్ ద ప్రాపర్టీ రేషియో Proprietary ratio is nothing but shareholders funds. It can compare only with the assets of the company. The assets say that only what is the compared just then, man funds are not there. So then man proprietary ratio is that we can find out. So what will be the formula for proprietary ratio? Shareholder funds divided by total assets. So when it comes to the other ratios, these are the various formulas we will learn. So we have learned about the profitability ratios, operating ratios, liquidity ratios, other ratios and the leverage ratios. So based on these formulas, we have to do the problems and we have to find out the ratio analysis of the company. So in the next video, I will explain about the problems. Thank you.